respect of the South China Sea. There is a strong consensus around the table. I'll ask the chairman of ASEAN to speak for ASEAN, but I think there is a strong consensus to ensure that the tensions are brought to an end by an agreement to a code of conduct, a binding code of conduct that will enable freedom of navigation, freedom of overflight to be maintained, and of course economic development to be undertaken.
Well, ASEAN countries all have broad and substantial relationships with China, cooperating over many issues in many areas. For many of the ASEAN countries, China is in fact their biggest trading partner. The South China Sea is an issue for specific ASEAN countries, which are claimant states. In particular, that means Vietnam, Malaysia, Brunei, and Philippines. It's an issue for the rest of the ASEAN countries too, because this is a security and stability question in the in Southeast Asia, which will affect all ASEAN countries if it goes wrong. I would say that the parties have been working towards discussing this issue and making progress on it. Last year, we agreed on the framework for the code of conduct between ASEAN and China. And this year, we have agreed to commence negotiations on the code of conduct. This is an issue which we can manage, which we can help to prevent from escalating.